Ungdomsrat.
Hello everyone, you are listening to You've Got 5 Options show with Marta and Anna.
Join us while we are solving yet another life challenge. And if you decide to share your problem with us, yours can be next.
Hello everyone, this is Marta.
And this is Anna.
And today we have a new technician who will say hello to us.
Hello from the technician.
Yes. So Lasse is having, I think he's having a day off or something, but he said he will leave us in a very good hands. So our technician's name is, it's Branko, right? Yes, he's waving to us with a hat. He's still not convinced if he would like to participate in a show. So we are not forcing him. Yeah, we can see your body language, so don't worry. But so today we are actually possibly only the two of us, Marta, just the two of us.
But we will give some opportunities to Branko to join us. Lasse was not so excited about joining us at the beginning either, and now he's almost like a co-host, so.
Yes, that's true. So, you know, just think about it, you know, just maybe you will feel an urge to say something, maybe. But you are not forced, remember, okay? Awesome. He showed us the thumbs up. So that's great, right?
That's definitely great. Mm-hmm. And guys, you are listening to You've Got 5 Options show, where we solve life challenges.
Yes, weekly, actually even 2 times a week.
Yeah, we are kind of now like on a very good production level.
That's correct.
So, guys, we have a challenge that we will be solving over the next 2 episodes. And whether you're listening to us on a radio show or on our podcast, you have to remember that you can find all our episodes also on our YouTube channel.
Yes, we have a YouTube channel and it's for free. And I cannot stress it more. It's for free. You can, Branko, you have to subscribe to our YouTube channel. So you can listen to our episodes from the radio show. But we also have a podcast and we are, yeah, you can find us everywhere, I guess, right?
Guys, we have more than 40 episodes so far. Mm-hmm. So there is a lot of funny and interesting topics to choose from.
Yes.
So we encourage you to visit our website, the5options.com, where you can find all our radio shows, podcasts, and also our articles.
And our super extra Photoshop pictures.
Definitely, yes.
Yes.
That's what you should go there for.
Amen. Fist bump.
Yeah, I think it's worth to mention because we actually made a huge effort to make that photo shoot, Marta. So
That was a tough day.
That was a tough day, yeah. But things you do for your website, you know. So, yeah, but guys, we also have written content because we write articles. So there is a huge library of the solutions that we have published as a written word because some of you like to read still. I think this is still an activity that many of you are performing from time to time. So on our website, you can find it all. So we hope that you will visit and we also are looking forward for your life challenges. Not because we are psychopaths and we like to read about people's problems, but because we like to help people.
Yeah, we do like to help people. And whenever you send your challenge to us, and it should be life challenge, it's not like a challenge on how to change a tire in the car. That may not be something we will be able to solve in a very creative way. But every time you send us your life challenge related to love, career, family, friendships, we provide you 5 options.
Yes, and we think that it's a super cool model because it worked so far.
Yeah, and it's usually fun and inspirational. So, you know, just do it.
Yeah, I think we just self-promote ourselves, Marta. I just hope
very
that you all heard it, you know, guys. Send us your life challenges. We can really help or make you laugh at least.
Totally. And now we will move on to Michelle's challenge. Michelle has quite a challenge, very interesting one. So, Anna, will you read it?
Yes, I will read it. But before I will read it, Marta, please tell me, is Michelle the real name or was it just a...
No, it's a name I came up with.
Okay, it's a beautiful name. And that's the last thing I wanted to tell you guys, that we don't require any data from you. So you can stay anonymous when you send us your life challenges. That's why we don't know who Michelle is. We don't even know if this is close to her real name. But that's something to consider. You know, you can stay totally anonymous.
Yeah, you can come up with your own name, or if you don't, we will come up with the name for you.
Exactly. Like Michelle, for instance. So here is the challenge. And it goes like this. I have been with my boyfriend for 5 years. We were really close friends before we started being together. And one of the main reasons for me to prolong the relationship was that I didn't want to lose my best friend. Now we are done as a couple. It was a common decision. And we would both like to remain to be friends. But I am not sure if that is even possible. We share the same awesome group of friends. And us not being able to continue the friendship would mean that the group has to split in one way or another. We'd like to give it a shot. What would be the best way to handle that situation? Michelle.
Oh, that's a tricky situation.
I give up. No, I don't give up. But friendship with exes, not my cup of tea.
Yeah, it's quite a tricky situation because it is difficult to be true friends with your ex. It is quite challenging and there are many things that can go wrong. It's a complex situation. But on the other hand, we totally understand Michelle because she's been friends with her ex-boyfriend for many years now. So it was a friendship before the relationship, and then they remained being true friends for the next 5 years of their relationship. They share a common group of friends. Mm-hmm. So it is quite a situation where I believe it is worthwhile trying it out.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. Of course, we don't know the details. And guys, another remark, and Michelle also for you, we will have to, of course, assume some things, because more details you will give us in your challenge, the better options we can come up with. But it looks like they were friends, very good friends before. So yeah, I would say that in this particular situation, I have a feeling there is a chance. However, I also remember one time when I saw a quote, probably on Facebook, if two exes can stay friends, it means that they never were in love or they still are. What do you think about this, Marta?
Well, I think it's a very interesting quote. And I think that in life, it's never, you know, black and white.
Yeah.
So I think... In general, I am not a big fan of staying friends with your ex. Mm-hmm. Because when the feelings were involved, when sex was involved, human relations are complex, are complicated.
Yeah.
And, you know, staying with your ex in a friendship causes just a lot of opportunities for drama.
Correct.
However, I also believe that if two people simply grow out of that relationship, mm-hmm. if both people... and the romantic part of that relationship, if they both feel that this is over and they are in peace with that, if no one feels brokenhearted, cheated, you know, these kind of things that make it very difficult after the relationship, I think it is possible. I think it's very difficult. It requires a lot of factors to come along, but I think it is possible.
Marta, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Are you a friend with any of your exes?
So I am not close friend with any of my exes, to be honest, but I have been friends with some of my exes after the breakup.
Mm-hmm. And do you think it was a good friendship or?
Well, I have to say that there were some traps in those friendships, like the romantic feelings were not necessarily over on both sides. Mm-hmm. And there were some repercussions after. The relationship was over, but I, with one of my boyfriends, I was actually friends for several years after we have broken up, and there was never any situation, never any drama, nothing bad has happened to anyone. Now we are not close friends anymore because we live in two different countries. We have set up our families and so on. But after the relationship was over, I was out of the country for another year or so. So I think the feelings, they had the time to go down. And then when I came back, we shared the same group of friends. And we did share the same group of friends. We did meet together regularly. We went for some trips together with the group of friends. And it was fine. There was no drama involved with it.
Yeah, because you know what? You know me for more than 20 years, mm-hmm. because we met each other in the uterus of our mothers. You know, that's the story from the first live show, which you can relive on our YouTube channel. But we are very young, spirit-wise. Anyway, we know each other for a long time. And I had for most of my life very optimistic and idealistic view of staying friends with your exes. And the premise was, this was someone really important in my life. We shared a connection, we shared intimacy, we shared memories. The fact that the feelings are gone and the relationship has ended doesn't mean I have to exclude this person from my life, because at one point this person meant a lot to me. However, I would say that my experiences and time has verified my idealistic view. And now I'm actually more on a side that it's very difficult, if not impossible, to stay friends with an ex. However, this is, you know, I'm saying this is my own experience, right? And another thing is what you have mentioned, because I was thinking, you know, about my relationships with my ex-boyfriends and my friends or anything like this. Here, the trick with Michelle is that she will be in a probably more like daily contact with an ex, right? Because I think it's quite easy to be, let's say, I could be friends with my first ex because we barely talk. And then when we would meet each other, we would have, I don't know, a beer, a coffee, a talk, and that would be all. There would be no drama. Although with him, you never know. But if you are keeping daily contact, that can be more difficult, because it's difficult to keep this, you know, that kind of a distant friendship.
Well, I would say, Anna, that knowing you for those 20 years and knowing the relationships you have, I don't think I have ever seen the relationship that ended because both of you came to a conclusion that you both no longer have feelings and you ended that that relationship in a mature, peaceful way where you could both actually agree that you should be friends.
Correcto.
Yeah, so I think that's where the trick is.
Yeah, that's also
it
correct.
It has to be on both sides, because yeah, you may come to a conclusion that this person was close to you, and just because you don't have feelings, why, you know, exclude that person from your life? But it can only work if both of you truly are over that romantic phase. There is another thing, that you are both in peace. No one mm-hmm. feels brokenhearted, no one feels cheated, and so on. Mm-hmm. And a third rule, I think both sides have to be quite mature.
Okay, I rest my case. But hit us with the options.
Yeah, so basically I do agree with you that it's very difficult mm-hmm. to be friends with an ex. It is really difficult because relationships are complex and it is difficult to stay out of the drama. But for you, Michelle, I have prepared 5 ground rules for a friendship between exes. So this is how we believe that a friendship could work. The rule number 1 is honesty. The rule number 2 is give each other time and space. Rule number 3 is each of you takes full responsibility for how you feel. Rule number 4, set the clear boundaries for your friendship. And rule number 5, set the rules for dating other people. So these are 5 rules, and we will begin discussing them in this episode, and we will finish discussing them in the next episode.
Yes.
So let's start with rule number 1, which is honesty. Mm-hmm. So I really think that for having any possibility for that friendship to work, both sides have to be honest. Both sides have to be 100% honest about their feelings toward each other. So that if any of you still have any romantic feelings, maybe you have to work on rule number 2, which is give each other time and space first before you can talk about any kind of friendship. But it's very, very important to be honest, because if you're not honest and there are still those feelings underneath, you know, boiling inside of you,
lurking from the darkness.
Yeah. Sooner or later, some drama might.
Especially with alcohol involved.
Yeah, maybe.
I'm not talking from my experience.
Unless your group of friends is like AA group of friends and you never drink any alcohol.
And vegans.
And vegans. You think meat has something to do?
Also, I'm sure.
That over a good steak?
Main joke.
I think that men really like turn a little bit animalic when they eat meat. That's my personal, very biased opinion. Biased? How do you pronounce biased?
Biased, I guess.
Biased, because lately someone is correcting me and telling me that this is not biased, it's something else, but I don't even remember.
Something like biased?
Biased, yeah.
Yeah, but maybe the reality is that both of them are correct, one in one country and the other one in the other country.
Exactly. So
potentially.
Potentially. So if there is no alcohol and meat involved, you have bigger chances. But Marta, honestly, this rule, I do have to say it's extremely important because I was thinking, why would you like to stay friends with your ex? So for instance, I gave you one reason, right? Which I thought this idealistic thing that I was always thinking, you know, you should keep people who meant something to you in your life. Michelle has a rather, I would say, practical reasons. She is talking about the awesome group of friends that they are both sharing, and she said something like, we wouldn't like them to, you know, fall apart, because I would understand from this description that the friends could go have to choose a side, with whom are we hanging out right now. So that is a second very valid reason to stay friends with your ex, because you don't want to destroy a nice group of friends that you have in general. But there is also another reason, and that is, you know, some people want to stay friends with their exes because they simply hope that something will maybe happen. And many times it's subconscious. You don't even know why you want to still have that person in your life. You tell to yourself, okay, this can be, you know, a friendship now, but you know, something inside you is lurking from the darkness. So that's why I think this honesty part, it's crucial. What are the real reasons? Because in the end of the day, Michelle, you can only talk for yourself. You know what your feelings are, and you say that there are no romantic feelings anymore, but you know how it really is with your boyfriend, ex-boyfriend.
And I think it's also important to mention that even in a situation where both of you truly believe that the romantic feelings are gone, they might be sleeping.
Yes, and that's why the mention about alcohol and meat.
They may return.
Yeah, it's really funny with people, you know, it's like, because sometimes it's not that you don't have feelings and they reappeared. Sometimes I think we are quite good at suppressing them. So sometimes I think it's just the suppressed feelings that might reappear. You are right, Marta. Do you think that there is always like a risk for people who are together to catch back the feelings?
I think there is always a risk for feelings can appear between any two given people.
That's a very diplomatic answer.
Yeah, because of course feelings can reappear. I think it's quite likely people, you know, the feelings go to sleep. I've heard so many stories and have several close friends who have been together with someone for a long time, for example, 10 years. Then they broke up. They took 5 years not being together.
Entered different relations. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Enter different relationships and they meet each other and it's like, whoa, what have I been doing all this time? It's like, it's you. So yeah, definitely it's possible. With us humans, everything is possible.
Message to the world.
Awesome. That's really comforting, because you never know what will happen. Expect the unexpected. But Marta, how would you then advise Michelle to approach the honesty part?
So I think that the honesty is, you know, you have to have an open conversation. And it seems like there is a good setup for that, as they have been friends before the relationship. They have apparently kept up the friendship during relationship, because Michelle mentions that she was even prolonging the relationship because she didn't want to lose her best friend. Mm-hmm. So it seems that the setup is fine for having this open conversation. And if an open, honest conversation is not possible, that just gives you the answer to whether the friendship is possible or not.
Correct. I also had a different ideas, maybe more unusual. Lie detector would do, I think. What do you think?
lie detector?
Yes, like to ask about, you know, the real feelings, the boyfriend and he's under the lie detector, and then you get to, it's become very popular right now, you know. Before, lie detector was used only like in courts and in, you know, that kind of cases. But now, I don't know if you know, but a lot of now women or men who are allegedly like having affairs with celebrities, in order to prove their point, they go to a tabloid or something and they go under lie detector. And then, you know, the tabloid has an article like, this person claims that had an affair with this married actor and she just went through the lie detector test and she passed it. So, yeah, apparently she had an affair. It's really funny. But, you know, lie detector might be even more and more used tool for honesty.
Very interesting approach.
Yes, I think it's progressive and a bit tabloidish, if that's a word. But, you know, it's like we have to think out of the box. I think another idea is to, you know, get that ex-boyfriend drunk and give him some meat and see how he will behave.
That's a very good test. So testing the honesty.
No, but Marta, if I'm to be honest, people who are under influence of alcohol, they tend to lose their, you know, some kind of walls, and they can actually start to tell the truth. Although it also worked the other way around, right?
Yeah, it also works the other way around, where I think there is truth to it, that we might lose our walls and we can then be, you know, honest. But you are right. There is also the risk where just a stupid idea comes to your mind and then you regret it forever and ever.
Exactly. Because then you are drunk and suddenly you are back in love with your ex. Then you get sober and you have hangover, and it's a physical and moral hangover. So that's not cool. So lie detector, I would suggest, from those more like progressive things. If, of course, Michelle, you have on hand a lie detector.
Bronco, would you like to tell us what you think about honesty? No. Friendship with an ex? No. Bronco stays true to his feelings about joining us on the show.
I know what we can do. We can ask him yes or no questions, which you don't even have to answer to microphone. You just show with the head and we can say. So would you take a lie detector test to prove your ex-girlfriend that you don't have feelings for her? No, he wouldn't. Okay, but maybe my solution wasn't so progressive now, I think.
Let's try to ask Bronco. Do you think that friendship with an ex is possible? Yes.
Okay. Okay. And do you think that honesty is the number one rule that you have to have for that? Yes.
So yes, Bronco said, yes, it's possible to be friends with an ex and that honesty is an important rule to have.
However, he wouldn't take a lie detector to prove it. So Bronco, what's on your mind? He's laughing.
Yeah, he's laughing. Okay. So maybe some personal experiences would have something here. But I would like us to move on to rule number two, which is give each other time and space. So when I was thinking about that rule, it was, when you break up with someone, even though it's a common decision, and even though you both believe that this is the best possible decision, it doesn't mean that there are absolutely no wounds or absolutely no feelings that have to heal. So I was thinking that probably at the beginning, it is a good idea to give each other a bit of space and time, you know, to completely cool down and simply learn how to live as a single.
Mm-hmm. I totally agree. And I have to say, Michelle, more and more I think about your challenge and the way you wrote it down. You know, on one hand, we have very pragmatic. We were friends before, very good friends, best friends. Their relationship ended, mutual decision. We both decided. So, but yet you do have this, like, is it possible to stay friends? Like, how can we do it? I would say if that would be more like straightforward, that, okay, we both have no feelings and you feel that and so on, it would be more like you wouldn't have doubts. Maybe there is something that is lurking in the darkness, and maybe space and time would be a good idea here.
Yeah, and that rule, when we mentioned the rule number one, honesty, and if any of you would still have some feelings lurking, the time and space should be reinforced and taken, you know, for a maybe longer period of time and space. But even if you both are done with that relationship, and even though you both are quite sure it's over, still for 5 years, you were in that group of friends as a couple.
Mm-hmm.
You had the physical contact, you were close to each other. It takes some time to unlearn what you've learned.
I totally agree. And I would like to remind you all people that life is not like in Friends sitcom or How I Met Your Mother sitcom, when they all basically had sex with each other and somehow are a really happy family. It's not that simple. And I think we would all love this to be as simple as it is. But yeah, I think it's not that simple at all.
Totally. And also the space could be understood as maybe you're not going to be such close friends like you used to be. So maybe it's also about accepting that you're just regular friends, that you are not best friends anymore. Maybe it's possible to have this kind of regular friendship where you hang out with the group of friends, but maybe the space will be necessary so that he's not the one you're calling when you are falling in love with a new guy, or he's not the one calling you for an advice with his new girlfriend, right?
Yeah.
So it could be, we will have some rules for how do you set up those things between each other, but that's also how I wanted to discuss the space time, space part, that it could also be the space in your friendship, in your new relationship.
Yeah, I totally agree. I don't think anything should be forced. Everyone should kind of like, you know, try to figure out what has happened. You know, I really wish that relationships would just end peacefully with a mutual understanding. We love each other.
Love is the answer.
As human beings, but not romantically. And now go prosper and I will be your best friend. But usually it's not that simple. Someone was hurting, suffering, has to unlearn something. So space is not such a stupid idea at all. Actually, it's very wise.
Yeah, so definitely we recommend when you end that relationship, allow a little bit of time and space. Maybe, you know, skip some of the friends' meetings once in a while, once you, once him. Just give each other a little bit of time and space. Maybe don't necessarily call each other every day or every week and to talk and so on, unless you are like really totally over and it's like the relationship has been over for 2 years and we were just sticking to it because we didn't want to break the group of friends and you really had all the healing done by now. But we assume that there is still something since you are coming up with this challenge. So yeah, we would definitely recommend time and space. And it's such a pity that we can't ask you, Bronco, how did you deal with ending your relationship and becoming friends with your ex?
Don't worry, we will ask him off air and then we will tell you all about it. No, okay. But he's smiling. I think Bronco is happy today. Are you happy? Yes, he's waving, he's nodding his head that he's happy. So we will see.
Okay, but that will be the two rules for today. Mm-hmm. And we strongly encourage you to listen to our next episode, where we will be discussing the remaining three rules. Each of you takes full responsibility for how you feel, set the clear boundaries for your friendship, and set the rules for dating other people.
Yes, sounds pretty awesome to me.
So thank you for today. Bye-bye.
Bye, guys. You are listening to You've Got 5 Options show, where we solve your life challenges.
Remember that you can visit our website, the5options.com, where you can submit your challenge or find our previous challenges. That's all, folks!
Du lytter til din lokale radio i Aarhus på FM 98,7 MHz og 89,5 MHz.
Radio i Aarhus på FM 88,7 MHz og 89,5 MHz.